Hi, in this video clip, let's discuss about universal shift register. A universal shift register will have the following functions. There is a clear control to clear the content of register to zero. That is, all the flip-flop will be forced to store zero upon activating the clear signal. Then we have a clock input to synchronize the operation of all the flip-flops in the register. Then we have right shift operation. The right shift control will enable the right shift operation, and the serial input and output lines associated with the right shift. We have left shift operation, and the left shift control will enable the left shift operation and the serial input and output lines associated with left shift. Then we have parallel load. The parallel load control will enable the parallel transfer of n input lines associated with parallel transfer. There are n output lines. Finally, to retain the information of the register, we have a control to keep the content of the register unchanged. These are the functions that are expected to be in a universal shift register. This is the block diagram that shows a shift register. We have parallel input line. This is for parallel transfer. This is parallel output line. This is common clock that is driving the operation of all the flip-flops inside the register. This is the clear input that will clear the content of the register to zero. And this is the shift right serial input, and this is shift left serial input. And these two are select lines which will determine whether the operation is shift right or shift left, or it is going to be a parallel load, or we wanted to keep the information unchanged. So one of these four operations will be chosen based on the input that we have for S0 and S1. When S0 and S1 gets the value of 00, we wanted to retain the content of the shift register. If S1 and S0 are 01 respectively, then we wanted to perform shift right. When S1 and S0 are 1 and 0 respectively, we wanted to perform left shift. Finally, when S1 is 1 and S0 is 1, we wanted to perform parallel load. This is the block diagram of the universal shift register. The circuit might look complex, but it is very easy to understand and draw without memorizing any of these things. We are going to draw the circuit for 4-bit register. Therefore, we will require 4 flip-flops. We are using D flip-flop. So, draw 4 flip-flops. Label the input D, the output Q. And to differentiate the flip-flops, we will label them as A0, A1, A2 and A3. So these are going to be the parallel outputs from the flip-flop. And all the flip-flops are synchronized with a common clock. So draw the clock that will drive all the flip-flops. Then there is a clear signal that will clear the content of flip-flops to zero. So we have a common clear pulse to all the flip-flop similar to the clock. Then all the input to the D flip-flops are connected via a 4x1 mux. So connect all the flip-flop inputs to the output of 4x1 mux. Why 4x1 mux? Because we have 4 different operations to perform, and we will keep the data to one of the lines and we will select that line accordingly using the select lines S1 and S0, which are common to all 4 4 by 1 mugs. So S0 and S1 are supplied to all the 4 by 1 mugs. Now let's see how to connect the input. We will start with the parallel load. When S1 and S0 are 1 and 1, we wanted to perform parallel load. That means that for the input line 3, we wanted to give the parallel load input. When S1 and S0 are 1 and 1, that represents 3 in decimal. That means that to this line 3, we are going to connect the parallel load input. So all the line 3 to mugs will be connected to the external input I0, I1, I2 and I3. So these are the parallel input lines. When S0 and S1 takes the value 0 and 0, it is no change. That means that we wanted to retain the information of the register. For S1 and S0 to be 00, it is no change. Therefore, we wanted to connect the line 0 of the mugs to the output of the flip-flop. So we will connect A3 to line 0 and A2 to line 0 of this mux, and A1 is connected to line 0 and similarly A0 is connected to line 0. So this is retaining the same value of the register. When S1 is 0 and S0 is 1, we wanted to perform shift right. When S1 is 0, S0 is 1, this is decimal 1. Therefore, we are going to use the line 1 of mux to feed in the shift right input. So this line will be connected to the serial input of shift right, and this will be fed externally. The flip-flop A2 should get the content of A3 for the shift right. So we will connect A3 to line 1 of this mux. That will give input to the flip-flop A2. Similarly, A2 content should come to A1. Therefore, we will connect this A2 to line 1 of the mux. That will feed the input to the flip-flop A1. Similarly, A1 will be connected to line 1 of the mux. That will feed in the input for the flip-flop A0. And finally, when the input to S1 is 1 and input to S0 is 0, we do the shift left operation. So this is decimal 2. So decimal 2 line input is connected to serial input for shift left. And when we perform shift left, the content of A0 should be fed to A1. So this line, which is A0 output, will be given to line 2 of the mux. That will feed the input to A1. Similarly, the content of A1 should be fed to A2. So A1 will be connected to the line 2 of the mux. That will feed the input to the flip-flop A2. Similarly, A2 will be connected to line 2 of the mux. That will feed the input to the flip-flop A3. Thereby, we will be able to perform all the 4 operations. We can clear the flip-flop input to 0 and then we can retain the information by supplying 00 for the select line, and when we supply 1-1 for the select lines, we can parallelly load the flip-flops from the external input, and then when we supply 0-1 for S1 and S0 respectively, we do shift right operation, and finally when we supply 1-0 for S1 and S0, we perform left shift operation.